It's 1:55 a.m., September 5th, 1944, and I've been on the train just 45 minutes. The porter probably thinks that I've made at least 20 trips across the country before, because I'm acting as though I'm a woman of the world.
It's the fall of 1944, and 20-year-old Doris Blumberg is on a 5-day journey to California. Her destination is the Monroe Army Base, where she'll work as a mathematician for the United States Army on a top-secret project to perfect precision aerial bombing.
I was absolutely delighted. Yes, I did think it was an honor. I was thrilled. And I thought that this was just an unbelievable thing to do.
Back home in Philadelphia, her twin sister Shirley is also an Army mathematician.
Yeah, we knew we had to do it. We knew we had to help out. If we were sending our troops over there to risk their lives, we certainly had to help out on this end.
From 1942 through 1945, all across America, women answered the call to help the war effort. Rosie the Riveter and female military units such as the Wax and the Waves were publicly celebrated for doing their bit, but elite groups of highly educated